City's entire police force just quit after what they were told to do. Now look what sign is up. Psychotic and immoral liberal behavior just cost a little town their entire police force. After dealing with repeated requests to act against the grain of the moral high ground that we want police officers to have, this small town police force quit. They're a small group of officers, but they held strong and quit together. Now there's a council meeting sign to address the issue. Michael Thomison and his entire police department in Bunker Hill have had enough of the motherfing snakes on this motherfing plane. Illegal requests from the liberal politicians whose only goal was to hopefully uncover some background nonsense on their political foes, which was of absolutely no benefit to the public and a clear violation of police code to inappropriately reveal information to the public about other residents. That's being seen in a shocking new case unfolding in Bunker Hill, Miami County, Indiana, where the entire police force has resigned because the town council repeatedly asked them to perform illegal, unethical, and immoral activities. By New York Daily News. This sort of behavior probably occurs more than we would like to admit and accept, but it's refreshing to know that there are some people who will stand firm to their duties who will not turn into backdoor mongrels abusing their powerful position. We need to bring dignity, honor, and respect back to good old-fashioned American values. Enough nonsense from these liberal buffoons trying to get cops to act improper when those liberal hacks are the first to trash a police officer when they make a mistake. What? Cops aren't human. Humans make mistakes, right? It's human nature to make human errors. The hilarious part of this is that it's just funny that liberals have a history of trashing police officers and here we are with them being the ones who quietly ask police to break the law. One of the main charges against the Bunker Hill Town Council is that they wanted to use the police to collect information on their political rivals. The police officers refused to take part in unethical abuses of their resources. What made the politicians think they could ask the police to break their rules when the politicians are sometimes the first people to talk down to police officers? What made the politicians think the police would waste their time researching politicians when the cronies in the offices probably have secretaries who could dig up just as much information? The resignation letter presented by the former officers states that members of the town council continuously requested background checks on fellow councillors. They wanted to uncover their criminal history. I'm glad the police officers said no to this. This sort of information should be available to everyone. If we're voting someone in or out of office, then we deserve to know their criminal history. We should be privy to facts about any and every candidate's background if they're running for any form of office, from small-time local bids to the President of the United States. Officers also resigned because the town failed to provide them with the funding and equipment necessary to face the dangers of their job. There was not enough quality body armor to go around, putting the policemen's lives at risk when out on the streets. This is a wonderful reason to quit. It's like not giving a star quarterback a helmet. You would want your star athlete protected when they're doing well on the field or ice, so how is this any different? All police deserve proper protective gear to hit the bricks and do one of the most hardest jobs there is, which is dealing with some of the worst people there are. Sure, handing out a speeding ticket is easy, but not when the driver is being confrontational or is under the influence and they're too stupid to stop arguing with the police. Thomason said, "I did not want to send someone out there with bad body armor, so I would take mine off and provide it to the other officers. I told them we have to provide this. There is an IC code that explains that and says that the town has to provide that body armor." Thomason pulled the trigger on a great decision. He expects to be treated better and be provided with sufficient protective gear for himself and his team of police officers. Imagine you were a hockey goalie and the coach, city, provided you with just an oversized jersey and some skates. No helmet. No leg, arm, or body gear. Nothing but the jersey and skates to putz around on while your opponent fires projectiles at your body. Unsafe and inhumane treatment of officers is not acceptable in any police district or city. For Thomason, there were also personal reasons relating to his resignation. He took time off after being diagnosed with cancer. But after he was prepared to return to work, the city would only give him part-time work. The city was playing with an officer's career as an intimidation game to cajole him into getting in line with their demands. The man fought a battle with cancer and still went back to work, and these scumbags treat him like that. You've got to be kidding me. What kind of liberal horse manure is this?
Please do not forget like on videos, and subscribe, and comment because your voice matters, and visit our page on Facebook, and like them, and follow up. And thanks for watching.